Good evening, Facebook and YouTube. Happy Walking Dead Season 9 premiere night. JDef has returned to give you exactly what you want, and you already know that's going to be giving my thoughts, my opinions, my expertise, and my expert analysis on a certain topic subject, which you already know is going to be regarding the Walking Dead Season 9 premiere titled A New Beginning. And before I get into details on that particular episode, you should know that there might be spoilers, and there will be spoilers, so if you haven't watched the episode or episodes previous to this, please don't watch the video because otherwise I'm going to spoil some. So you have been warned. So let's get started with the episode, what I liked about the episode, and kind of what I didn't like. So let's start with what I didn't like about the episode. And I like to go back and forth and kind of go out of order on things. But what I did not like about this episode for a Walking Dead premiere night, there was no Negan in the episode. Okay, well, they talked about Negan a lot, but he wasn't in the episode. Apparently that was done by design because the last episode they had before this was all about Negan. I'm sorry, Negan's one of your central characters on the show now, especially with everybody else leaving the show. He needs to have a major focal point in every episode. You cannot have him not be in an episode. But I guess they didn't have him in the episode, and I'm a little mad about that. So no Negan makes me annoyed, so the episode already isn't going to get a good score. But here's some good things. There was some good things about the episode. First, well, not in any particular order, but you had King Ezekiel propose to Carol, as there was about a year and a half time skip in between, you know, the Savior's surrendering and this particular episode. So Carol and Ezekiel have stepped up their relationship and are essentially dating, and now they're at the point where they want to go to the next step, I guess, but Carol did not say yes because we all know Carol loves Daryl, and that's the whole point of the show, is to hook Carol and Daryl up at some point. And then discussing that, might as well get into the fact that Daryl actually had more dialogue for once. He didn't just have grunts and moans and whatnot, so that was nice. I mean, the show now has a new showrunner. It's not Scott M. Gimple anymore. It's Angela Kang. Scott M. Gimple's like the creative control consultant or something. He actually promoted himself or got promoted, but Angela Kang's the new showrunner on the Walking Dead now, and she has a good way of developing characters and relationships with characters, and I certainly saw that in this episode, so that was good. Another thing I liked about the episode was the part where the Sadiq was almost bitten by the spider walker with all the spiders on it. That was pretty cool. I think they want to give more of the horror aspect to the show back. So that was a pretty cool suspenseful moment, especially for those of you that don't like spiders. I don't necessarily mind them anymore, but certainly it's something that in previous times used to bother me. So that was one other thing. And then of course at the end of the episode you have the spoiler alert, death of Gregory as he tries to set up Maggie, and Maggie's had enough. And Maggie to set an example for everybody else, Maggie hangs Gregory. So we will have no more Margaret or whatever the hell he wants to call Maggie anymore. Gregory is dead. So, I mean, it was an interesting episode. It wasn't the best episode. I mean, I'm still mad that there was no Negan in it. I mean, they mentioned him a lot, but there was no Negan in the actual episode. But yet, he was on Talking Dead, and they said that was by design, to, you know, just have him not be in the episode. But whatever the case may be, from now on, they should not do that, especially in a premiere episode. Everybody should be the focal point. That's why you have an extended episode, an hour and 26 minutes, to fit everybody in there. But I don't know. I guess I don't really care. It was good. It was certainly interesting. The suspenseful moments with, you know, King Ezekiel falling through the glass and almost getting bit. Another thing I didn't like, sorry, I'm kind of going out of order here. The new character that they introduced, the younger kid, just to get killed off. Why do you focus on killing characters that have no focal point to the show just to advance the story? It's weak writing, in my opinion, but, I mean, it made a better story in terms of the Gregory thing, because his dad and mom, you know, Gregory used his dad at least to try to get Maggie, and he didn't really want to do it. So that was interesting. But I think that's pretty much it about the episode. If I had to rate it, I'd probably say it's an 8.7 out of 10, because it had some good moments in it. I mean, obviously this season's going to be really crazy, and they're just setting it up for even a bigger episode. But I'm just mad that Negan wasn't in the episode. That's my main concern. No Negan, and of course, no Morgan. We don't know when Morgan's going to come back. I sense he will come back at some point. We don't know when. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Please, you know, if you have an opinion on the episode, you should comment. You should like at least. Thumbs up or thumbs down, whatever. Love it. Laugh at it. Wow it. Oh, wow it, as DeMarcus would say. You know, do what you got to do. But that was The Walking Dead Season 9 premiere tonight. And, of course, I'll be back talking about The Walking Dead probably again this week, but definitely next Sunday, because Walking Dead Sundays are going to be our nights to talk about The Walking Dead. So enjoy the video, leave a comment, and I'll catch you later.